over the obstacle, vertical force and rate at the top. Again, you can see the very low damping. The tire takes a very long time to damp out. Very little lateral movement. It's never possible to drive in a perfectly straight line, but in this case, the lateral forces are small, but there are some longitudinal forces. As you go onto the bump and off a bump on the other side, you get some longitudinal forces that you can measure. Pitch velocity again, so all the additional measurements that are available on this test setup. This shows vertical acceleration in two positions. The red line shows a vertical acceleration on the toe, while the black line shows a vertical acceleration above the tire. It's important to realize that the movement of this tire tester will influence the movement of the vehicle. So even driving in a straight line at a constant speed, you cannot assume that the toe is perfectly still. The toe has some movement, which we need to take into account in the final Evans model. So you can see here the tire tester model driving over a discrete obstacle. The graph on the right hand side shows the respective forces measured in the Evans model. You can see the very low damping as the tire moves onto the obstacle and from this obstacle at the end. And the red graph at the bottom is just a simple point for the, the top graph is a Pacheco model, so that's a point follower tire model in Adams. The bottom graph is a measured result. We are in the very early stages of trying to implement different tire models and try to compare them. But we believe that we have enough test data now so that if any one of you are interested in testing your own tire model against this test data, we can do those kinds of things. So the idea really now is to implement and parameterize different tire models, put them in the Adams simulation, and then see how well the simulation results compare with what we actually measured on the test data. So to summarize, a lot of our tests are done on the test track, different surfaces, different roughness, with two different tire testers. But we also do laboratory testing to parameterize some of the tires, things like the nozzle analysis, in order to get good tire models. So we're not at this stage developing tire models. We're hoping that one of the tire models out there might be applicable to the specific circumstances if properly parameterized.
We have time for a couple questions for Dr. Ellis, if you would like.
Have you run any with run flats and tire pressure variations?
The tire that we are testing at the moment actually has a run flat in, but amplitude of excitation is not high enough to excite the run flat tire at the higher tire pressures. You go to the lower tire pressures, it becomes important. We haven't done that. But the same, it could be done. You could deflate the tire and do the same test with a run flat. Although on those rough terrains, I won't advocate that idea.
It
will
be very interesting when you compare, for example, tractor tires on hard road and in fuel conditions.
Yes.
In this,
we'll be to go to the field condition because we can use exactly the same test setup. We haven't done that. We haven't also looked at the mechanics aspects, but on the longer term plans is to actually fit the braking system or the propulsion system to this. But in our opinion, we don't really know what's going on hard surfaces yet. So a lot of you are working on thermal mechanics, but the hard surface, rough terrain issue is already a